science lesson not only teaches science concepts, but it incorporates other subjects as well. These lessons, while using multiple materials and various steps, tap into the most basic human emotion, curiosity. And here with us today is Michael Compton from the Blue Springs School District, and he is going to demonstrate for us how he was able to do this in his classroom.
The lesson I used were Mexican jumping beans, and what we did was we went through the life cycle of the Mexican jumping bean.
All right, so Michael, can you tell me what did you have to do with your students prior to this lesson in order to get them ready for this?
When we started the lesson, we had to use our process skills, and we used our process skills in the first 20 days of science. And what we did was we focused on observation, and the character we used was Mr. Potato Head. Mr. Potato Head reminds us to use our sight and our ears and all the different parts of Mr. Potato Head, and so they observed these Mexican jumping beans.
Great, great. So as far as the materials, it seems like, were these hard to get? Were they hard to come by?
Actually, I got them on eBay. We had the Picture Perfect ladies came to present to Ice 5, and they said that you can get them from Mexican jumping beans or us, but I needed them pretty quick. So I went through eBay and got them. Then obviously I had a heating pad and a thermometer, all very easy things to get.
So on eBay, so how much do they cost? Do they sell them in bunches, or how do you get these things?
It was about $15 with shipping for a class set.
Well, Michael, I think a lot of teachers might be thrown off by this lesson just to see this Mexican jumping bean. They might be worried that it would cost too much to do it, but it's obvious that you were able to get these on eBay without very much expense.
And my wife used these after I was done with them. She's also a teacher, teaches fifth grade. And I also thought that I could share them with other people within the district because I bought these in October, and I mean, they lasted for over a month as long as I keep them in the refrigerator. So I could share them with other fifth grade teachers within the Blue Springs School District. Watch it very closely. In this part, the kids were focusing on observation. They weren't jumping to any conclusions. They were just looking.
No pun intended.
No pun intended, exactly. So they were just observing the beans with their magnifying glasses, and they also had a tape measure, and they were looking at the beans with strictly observations. Looking at it very closely.
It's moving.
Whoa. Is it moving? What's it look like? What's its size?
Oh my God. Mr. Compton, awesome. This thing is freaking me out.
All right, so now they've actually filled in the O on their chart, so what they observed about the Mexican jumping beans. What does the W stand for then?
The W stands for wonder, and what they did with this, they observed the beans for a little bit, and then they're curious about things. Why is it jumping? Why is it moving? And that's what they're gonna write in the wonder part. What do you wonder about this item? What do you wonder?
No.
Jake, what do you wonder? What do you wonder, Jake?
Well, I wonder why it moves.
You wonder why it moves. That's been the question of the day. What do you wonder? Chris, what do you wonder?
What's in there?
What's in there? What do you wonder, Jackson?
Is it alive?
Is it alive? Do you wonder anything, Yvonne? What it's called? What is it? How about where is it from?
From a tree.
Is it from a tree? Is it a living thing?
I loved all of the things that your kids were curious about. That's what's great about a good science lesson. So can you tell me how you addressed all of those things that they were wondering about?
So a lot of the things they wondered about were addressed through Lucas and his Loco Beans, this book here. It talked about how what was inside the bean, that it was a larva inside the bean, and they where the beans are from. So
you actually read this book to them, and it gave them the background information that they needed on the beans?
Yes. Some other things that we'll be looking at. Abuelo, Verano, Lugar, Somalias, Polillas, and then those are in Spanish. You're gonna try to figure out what they mean in English.
Everybody's trying to look at.
Abuelo, abuelo, I yelled as I ran. I hugged him and held him, grabbed hold of his hand. And here's the picture. What do you think Wyatt abuelo might mean? It's one of our words, abuelo.
Hey or hello.
Abuelo, abuelo.
Wait.
No. I yelled as I ran. I hugged him.
Father.
Father or, I think even older.
Grandfather.
Your grandfather. Abuelo means grandfather.
All right, see, and I love how you incorporated reading with that. I love how you were able to incorporate social studies with it being from Mexico. And so are you able to walk us through the experiment and kind of let us know what you did?
Yes, I can. The first thing they did was they each had their own bean, and I told them that they need to watch the bean and observe it. And so I timed the whole class for a minute, and they were supposed to count the number of movements they saw at room temperature of the bean.
Are you ready?
Yes.
This is at room temperature for 1 minute. On your mark. Get set, start counting.
So they're counting.
So they're keeping track of that. And I had them do it with a partner because fifth graders tend to extend the truth a little bit, you might say.
I can't imagine that.
And time, write your number down, please.
And so they watched it at room temperature, and then we recorded all the results, and they wrote it down on a sticky note. And they brought the sticky note up to me on the board, and I put them in order from smallest to largest, and then we went into the median. So I incorporated some math with the lesson.
Think about what we've talked about with science and how we want to collect a lot of data. We have a lot of data up there. How could we get the number average for this class? What could we do? Kirsten.
For the average?
Yeah, what could we do?
We could have someone that's really good at math in here, add all the numbers, and then...
I don't want to add things today. I don't want to do that. I know you'd want to do it. I don't want to do it today, though. I want to do it pretty quick. What could we do? Blake.
Cross off the first one, then the last one.
Come on up, Blake.
Continuously do that.
Come on up, Blake. Go on that end down there with the zero. Does anybody know what that's called when we take one off each end till we get to... What, Kiera?
Median.
You're exactly right. Come on up, Kiera.
Good job.
Wait, Blake. I'll tell you when. Okay. When I tell you guys to go, take one off. Okay? And each time I tell you to go, take one off. So go, 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 and go.
No.
And Addie had the lucky number 25, and that is our median jump for the class.
Then we came to the heating pads. And first we measured the temperature of the heating pad, and it was warmer than it was at room temperature. Then they were doing the exact same thing. They were observing the number of times that it moved. And again, we did the same exact thing.
Ooh,
that one's going crazy.
So well, I take it that heat makes them move a little faster?
Heat makes them move, and that's addressed in Lucas and his Loco Beans.
Okay.
Actually, in Spanish, I can't remember the exact words.
Lucas, take some beans in your mano, and you'll see your warm body los hace mover like crazy. The Loco Beans were snapping and clicking in my hand. They wiggled and moved, and I thought, oh man, los hace mover means makes them move. So your warm body los hace mover like crazy. So your warm body makes them move like crazy.
So you did informally assess them by having them fill out that last letter, L, in their OWL chart.
And the L stands for learned. And what we did was we were looking at all the facts from the book. And then there was a sheet that went along with the Picture Perfect science lessons that tells you more facts about the Mexican jumping beans. So that's what I was looking at informally.
Complete your OWL chart, please, using some of the information from here, what you've learned today.
So can you tell me, what do you think went well in the lesson?
Well, what I really loved about this lesson was the fact that all the students were actively engaged. They were all so curious about these things, and they wanted to hear a story. And it's really hard to get fifth graders to want to hear a story, but they wanted to hear the facts that went along with it.
So they could find out what it was.
And they were able to incorporate math in a real-world situation that wasn't just, here's the median. They actually measured the beans jumps or hops, and then they were actually to put that math into a median.
So Michael, just being a teacher on the Ice 5 Science Grant, I know from day one that you have been taught that your lessons need to follow the 5E learning cycle. Do you see the value in that? How does that help your lessons flow?
Well, using the 5Es, the important part is getting those students engaged. So when I use like the Picture Perfect science books, I can incorporate other subjects into my lessons. So they're engaged in the science to start with, and science fits so nicely to it. I can add in Comm Arts with like a Picture Perfect book, or I can also add math like I did with this lesson. The kids, once you engage them in the lesson, they are so into it.
Well, thank you so much for sharing your lesson with us. And you can download the complete lesson and ideas and tips for teaching science at the ICE 5 website, www.ice5.net. And we'd like to thank our sponsors today, as well as the Blue Springs, Hickman Mills, and Center School Districts.